We're down at the Finest Gym in Ancoats, home of the WBO lightweight champion Terry Turbo Flanagan, one of the best trainers in Britain, Steve Maylett, and seriously, the rest of the stable ain't too bad either. Come on, follow me. As you can see, action is underway. Okay, look who we've got in the house. It's Mr. Dale Coyne. It's the Ancoats Alvarez, one time. Now, firstly, why do they call you the Ancoats Alvarez?
I imagine it's supposed to do with the air.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah, I didn't realise you. Dale, we've just seen you training here. I mean, what I love about you is that your style is... I got a feeling you're going to be in some exciting fights. You've got an all-action style.
Yeah.
Your last time out, which actually was aired on Box Nation, you looked pretty sensational. Tell us about your last fight.
Well, it was a last minute replacement, right. Funny enough. It was meant to fight a lad called Mark Till. It was just a basic journeyman, like. And the last minute, Steve rang me up the day before and said, "I've got a new kid. He's just beat a 5-0 lad."
Yeah.
Straight away, that puts you on your toes, like. Yeah. I've got a minute on the YouTube, we watched him. I knew he'd have the beating of him. He'd come out flying. That's just what I like, to come back to the corner. Steve said he was waiting for me to say, like, "Wow, what we're gonna do now?" Like, yeah. I just said to him, "I'm loving this. This is my style of fight." He just sort of knew then I had control of it. But the cuts man who was in the corner in the second round said to Steve, "It's a close one, this Steve. What's gonna go on here?" So Steve turned around and said, "Oh, wait, you'll catch him with something." And as soon as I said that, and they all do with that.
Well, I liked the fact that he actually gave you a bit back in the third round, and that's when you thought, you know what, you just went for him.
Yeah.
So almost in a sense, like you got hit a tiny, tiny little bit in the third round, and that was it. You were just on it. So
yeah.
Is that kind of the way you like it? You like to be in a fight?
No, not there, lad.
Right.
No one likes being punched.
Yeah.
But at the time, if you would have been hurting me with the punches, I would have boxed, but he wasn't hurting and he wanted him very clean.
Yeah.
And every shot I was hitting was quite full-blooded.
Yeah.
So I knew he wouldn't be able to stand up to it.
What I noticed as well though, obviously offensively you've got a lot of power, but actually you were pretty comfy on the back foot. You were comfy, you know, your back against the ropes a couple of times, but just comfy, just watching.
Wow.
So it's defensively, is that something you look at as well?
Yeah, I'm more of a defensive fighter. Oh, when I first come to stay, my defence was good. But I was too defensive, I was on the ropes too much. Yeah. And not firing back, just willing to take them on the gloves and be happy with that. But now I'm learning to fire and catch and go at the same time. Trying to take the wind out of their sails as they're putting on me, like. And I've got a lot more relaxed in there with constantly doing technique now with the new lads in the gym than my weight. So getting a lot more technique, getting a bit more comfortable taking shots and being relaxed on the inside.
Well, yeah, what fighters do you actually like watching? Because I noticed you use quite a few tricks that I've seen before with people, like Carl Frampton, the way you use your arms.
Yeah.
And I've noticed as well the way you rock back and you know, the way you rock back off the rope. So which fighters do you like the look of?
I watch Alvarez, obviously.
Standard.
I like the way he's offensive, but now he's bringing a bit of a defensive game.
Yeah.
So when you start seeing him short
and stuff.
So he's starting to bring that in. And Andre Ward, love watching Ward.
Well,
that's where I get my arm.
That's
from.
Where you get it from, yeah,
touching
right.
Touching with the arm and doing the little checks with the arm. I love watching it. I mean, people say he's boring, but he's just a genius, isn't
he? He is a genius. Now, when are you next out? Tell us a little bit about that.
Back out, hopefully, on Teddy's belt sometime in April. It's not been confirmed yet, but I should be on that. And undercard with Teddy, I think Lecky's on that as well. So,
fantastic.
Should be good if we all go out.
Yeah, and that should be a big card, so a bit of exposure and everything like that for you.
Yeah, well, you need it. Now, it's good being on Box Nation, but it's only, I think, hardcore boxing fans that are going to subscribe to Box Nation.
Yeah.
Now it's on BT.
And I got it on my phone and everything. I've got it everywhere I go with me.
Yeah, yeah. But you're a hardcore boxer.
That's it.
No, but now BT seems to be taking over the game, doesn't it? Even with the Premiership and Champions League.
It's a massive deal, that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Could really be a game changer, that.
So it can open the eyes to the casual boxing fan.
Yeah.
You know, it's like Ricky Hatton fans. Not all of them are probably boxing fans. You're just a fan of the man, aren't you? So,
yeah.
Because
he
got that exposure. Casual people just get to know him.
A lot of that's to do with the football as well. Who's your team?
United.
Right. Well,
on the other
can
side.
Can we edit that bit out? Because you're in a gym here with quite a lot of blues, aren't you?
Yeah, well, Teddy's a big blue.
He's a big blue, isn't he? Yeah.
But Steve's the main man, he's the red, so if the puck comes to shove, we'll probably slip him out.
Quality. Alright then, so basically this year, just looking to build on what you've got already, great platform, and just try and get yourself out there. Is that the plan?
Yeah, just get the exposure, fights, like I said, try and be as excited as I can in the ring.
Now, you were quoted as saying boxing is an easy way to make money.
Someone told me that. I must have said that when I knocked him out.
Yeah.
No, it's not easy, but it's easier to make. It just comes more natural to me than doing graphic. I have worked on sites, and that's hard work to me. That. Yeah. Getting in the ring's just second nature.
I mean, seeing how hard you guys work, I can tell you, I can tell anyone out there, these guys put the work in as well. Listen, it's been an absolute pleasure. Looking forward to seeing you out again. This is Dale Coyne, the Ancoats Alvarez, coming for you all. Power! Alright, we're moving on now. Right, nice one, man.
Stop
right,
mate.
Next we'll keep him going. Right, okay. Follow me. We're here with the man himself, it's Mr. Steve Maylett. Now, looking at your guys working hard here, you're developing a fantastic stable.
Yeah, working hard tonight, it's just more a conditioning session. Decided to bring the lads in over the last few weeks together. Because the fitness level, well, we're just starting camp for a lot of them, so don't need to have my eye on the one-to-one. I've been doing that on the Tuesday, Thursdays, and Monday, Wednesday, Friday for a few weeks. It's been hard work sessions. Let's get them strong again. Let's get them fit.
Christmas puddings.
Oh, yeah, there's a few been on the Christmas puddings. Twixes, Kit Kats,
Snickers for me, sweet. But, you know, I'm not a prize fighter. So I just wanted to ask you, from a technical point of view, I mean, trainers, a lot of the time, the fighters get a lot of the credit. And that's obviously because they can go in the ring. But trainers like yourself, you're in a gym with loads of talent here. Each one's got a different style. How do you manage to sort of balance that and take into account everyone's different style when you're training them?
Yeah, it's hard. A lot of the conditioning and stuff, what we do, most of the lads will do it. But when it comes down to perfecting the style, which is what you've got to do, because if you base it, it's too easy to read. You'll only get to a certain level, no matter how fit, how strong you are, how much you want it. At a good level, it's usually skills or whoever wants it more in there. Mm. They're the two things it comes down to, because they usually all got good coaches. Yeah. They've all done the strength work, they've all done the diet right, and then on the night it comes down to skill, or like I say in there. So perfecting the style is, they've all got their own individual style. Mm. That's great, but they need to perfect it.
Yeah.
And when they do, and they make it hard work for opponents to read them, that's when they become successful.
How much do you actually analyse opponents? Do you read?
I watch a lot of videos. Yeah. I like to know them inside out. I watch just watch the fights. I like to know what they're doing on a daily basis as well.
So
I know them as good as they know themselves by the time it comes to fight night.
Yeah.
I watch any training they've done, even amateur fights, everything.
And when it comes down to the, I know there's a lot of trainers that are very analytical, so they have a lot of the computer technology and they do all that sort of stuff and they're counting the punch rates for each round. How much of that do you kind of do, or do you like to strip it back and have more of a basic approach?
One of the things that I said, what I've done from the start of the coaching career really is that I look at what the best at what we try to take that often, because they're going to do what they're good at, and they're not going to come in and do what's bad. They're going to try and come, and if they've got a good jab, they're going to try and work the jab if they're good at going to the body. That's what they'll do. We try and take their best asset away from them.
Right.
So we'll train for when they do what they're good at, and we'll turn it and flip it on to make it good.
Yeah. Well, it's great to hear that from an actual trainer who's done it, you know, like, it's just interesting to get in your head about that. How does it feel coming from where you come from? You know, like being with people like Terry from the beginning, you know, coming up, being friends with them, almost like brothers rather than trainer relationship. And then sort of developing your stable and then to what it is now, which is a room full of champions and prospects. How does that make you feel?
Yeah, feels good. It's been hard work.
Yeah.
You get out what you put in, and you put a lot in, Terry has. I have, and then obviously people are looking at Terry's success.
Yeah.
And then probably thinking, he must be a good coach because he's doing well with it.
Well, everyone in the industry, every time, you know, we're talking about great trainers in Britain, always mention your name. And, you know, you mentioned Terry there. How does him being the world champion rub off on the rest of the lads?
I don't really ask him because I set high standards anyway, so I don't really what I'm looking to win for motivation. I'd rather them look to me, to be honest, because I'm the one who's in there with them on fight night. And if they need that G up, it should be me it's coming from. So I think I'd like to think of providing enough motivation, but I think what's good is they can see a path. Yeah. Somebody's done it before and that. So they know when they come to this gym, they know they've got a good coach, I know what I'm doing, and if they come in and they work hard, they can get there. They can tell they've got there. Why can't somebody else?
Yeah. And a lot of fighters who are sort of just turning over or you know looking to turn over are looking to you as well now. Interestingly, Anthony Leaf, who's out, he's had one pro fight with you, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Can you tell us a bit about the story there? Because I think you were both amateurs at Northside, is that right?
Yeah, he was probably, well, it sounds daft, but he was probably about 11, and I was probably, I was maybe 17, so
yeah.
To me, he was a baby at the time,
yeah,
you know, and
yeah.
I was probably a junior moving on to a senior, but I remembered him in the gym, and he was good.
Yeah.
You know, I won't want to stop about and watch other people training. I went in, trained out, but what I remembered of him as a young kid, he was flashier, and then as I started getting into the coaching Terry at Northside and Kyle Place, Lecky was still fighting, so obviously I'd be there on fight night, and he beat some good kids.
Yeah.
I knew he was a good amateur.
Beat some good kids in the amateurs, didn't he? Beat Tommy Langford, Callum Smith in the amateurs, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, so brilliant. I mean, some other exciting, we're going to have a chat with everyone, some other exciting people as well to watch out for. Just great times for the gym, really.
Yeah, and we've got to be busy with them all this year. That's the aim, get as many wins as possible.
Yeah.
And keep the lads active.
Yeah.
And a lot of them are at that 4-0, 5-0, 6-0, and they need to be in there boxing probably once or two.
Yeah. And a quick word just before we actually go and have a chat with him on Terry Flanagan this year. If you look back at last year, 2016, you know, for the champ, were you happy with the year on average?
Yeah, I felt like after they beat Magdaleno, I probably should have continued moving forward. But we didn't get the big names that we wanted, so that wasn't Terry's fault. He put himself out there. Our promoter offered a bit of money about, but they didn't want to fight. They didn't want to fight with happen for whatever reason. But this year, we've gone and had one more, and then it'll either be a unification fight or a tough fight against Verdeo, who'll be the mandatory.
Yeah.
I think by the summer comes, hopefully unification or the mandatory.
Well, that'll be brilliant, because if anyone deserves a fight like that, it is Terry Flanagan.
Yeah,
it really
rise
is
to the occasion.
Yeah.
We're waiting for that. Like I say, since the Magdaleno one, he's not had the opponents to turn him on.
What's it like to have a champ who's offering his title up to all contenders and they don't want to fight him? Because what do you think that is? Do you think it's because he's too good, he makes people look bad?
I think they think obviously he's unbeaten for a reason.
Mm.
They know he covers every aspect of his training, but they might think he's awkward, they might think it's hard to look good against him, he don't lose rounds. So when they're looking at him on the videos, they might think I could beat him, and then I think when they have a second glance, they probably think it'll be an hard night.
Yeah, definitely. And we're seeing a lot, just on the final note, we're seeing a lot of talk of catch weights, you know, with the boxers. You see people like Kelbrook going up to fight Golovkin, you've got people like Amir Khan going to fight at Canelo weight or whatever that weight is that he's fighting at. How far would you go to get that big fight in terms of weight and things like that?
Well, I think the lightweight division's probably one of the best in the world.
Yeah.
So there's probably people waiting for Terence Crawford to move up, and then what a jump up, which is something we'd be interested in ourselves. But I think what would happen is we'd go, probably Lenarda's a jump up, Mikey Garcia's a jump up, and then you've probably got a couple of names anyway, so that division would still be as hard, no matter what. So we'd be jumping to try and become a two-weight world champion.
Yeah.
But it wouldn't be any easier. Probably be harder or as hard.
Yeah. Well, listen, it's great to see like your gym's in full flow and that you know you're having all getting the success that you've really laid the foundations for and reaping the successes now. Thanks for talking to us, man. Really appreciate it. We're gonna go on to talk to Mr. Bulger over here. All right, listen. Can we grab you? Listen, we were just about to go and do some pull-ups there. That was good timing, that, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So, how are you getting on? All good?
Yeah, all good, mate. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just waiting on a date or some news. Yeah.
How are you feeling? How did you view last year? How did you feel like it went for you?
A bit frustrating. I wanted a few more fights, but it up on. So.
Is there a reason why you probably didn't have as many fights as you wanted last year?
I'm not too sure, to be honest. Tickets and stuff like that. Yeah, yeah. So yes, it's hard.
See, that's the thing. People don't realise. It's not just like there's a fight date, get on with it. There's lots of other factors to take into consideration.
Yeah, it's not as easy as to turn up and fight.
In many ways, though, has that made you sort of a bit more hungry for it this year?
Yes, I've got a bit of a chip on my shoulder. I want a decent fight, I want something meaningful.
For people who haven't seen you too much just yet, can you tell them a little bit about your record, your weight, everything like that?
6-0. What's that lightweight up to now?
It's getting echoed in the background as well.
I'm going to be doing super feather, you know, the day before weigh-ins and championships and stuff, so a bit of timber on now, but it'll soon be off.
You know, it doesn't look like he's got too much timber on to me. Style-wise, what's your sort of fight style like?
I like a bit of a scrap, but Steve's trying to get that out of me. It's one of the bad things, but other than that, long boxing and have a scrap when I can.
So you said there's not an official date for your next out this year, but what are you looking? How many fights are you looking to have this year then? We're talking about 6+ or?
Yeah. All depends, it's just how it goes, how as many as possible.
Yeah, real. Are you looking at? I know you're sort of only sort of into your career, but are you looking at the British rankings and just looking at?
Just round there, there's loads of lads around my way coming up, so there's good fights to be made. Me and Kallum in here, and then there's Dale Canelo Coyne. There's loads of names, Chris Conway, there's loads. So.
Really good fights made, and just gone
through derbies.
That's it, man. We like a local derby, don't we? We love it.
Manchester.
That's it. Actually, talking to Manchester, just in general, the Manchester fight scene at the minute is absolutely buzzing, isn't it?
Yeah, it's going mad at the minute. Success breeds success. Everyone else is just feeding off it, and it's amazing.
Absolutely. And tell us a little bit about working with Steve Maylett here.
Yeah, it's mint. Look at the lads in the gym. There's pure talent about. Everyone's looking to Terrace. He goes into his training, and everyone wants to get where he is. So
fantastic. I'm gonna put you on the spot here. Can you look at the camera and tell everybody what to expect from you this year?
Big things. Big things.
That's it, baby. He keeps it short and sweet. That's how we roll.
Good amateur.
Say again.
Great. Good amateur, Jake.
Tell us a little bit about them, man. Tell us a little about your amateur pedigree.
I didn't feel I did as good as I could have in the amateurs. I boxed some good kids, boxed myself, or boxed all little kids in the air. I didn't really take it as serious in the amateurs. I sort of turned up and fought it.
What do you make of the whole thing with the amateur scoring? A lot of people turning over because they had a bad decision or they just don't like the amateur system.
Yeah, I was on the bad end of the view. I've had it where the other kids told me one of the better referees said I've won, but none of that matters because it's the three judges that matter.
You seem to have a good style for the pros. Listen, man, we wish you all the best this year. Look out for this guy. Watch out. Power! Right, I'll tell you what, I can see Callum Dieth over here. Come on, follow me. Still here, still with me. Callum, can we get a little chat with you?
Yeah.
How's it going, man? All good?
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, so you're a bit late today, what's going on?
Oh, just working late.
Yeah.
A bit busy in work.
Alright, tell us about what's going on with you this year then.
We're fighting out in Boxton. March 18th, I think it is.
Yeah.
And there's talk about me fighting Andy Townsend.
For the Commonwealth title.
Yeah. Nice.
So is that something that you've been looking at for a while then, or is it just popped up at the scene?
Well, we're going for the English against him, but then he turned around and said that he don't want to defend his English again, he wants to move on to better things. Well, I'll go for the Commonwealth, but Walsh has got the Commonwealth, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Okay. So if he vacates it, I think me and him will fight for it.
So for people out there who haven't sort of seen you fight too much, tell us a little bit about your record, about how long you've been at the gym, a bit of stuff like that.
I've been here about 2.5 years, I think, now. Yeah. Won 10, lost 1. I've had 6 or something. One all of them.
Yeah.
I've had my first stoppage with him as well last year.
What is it about the relationship there in the Dallas gym that he thinks working for you?
He looks after you, that's what he wants. Yeah. He's there for you all the time. If you've had any problems tonight, you can just ring him.
Yeah.
And he sorts it out.
Right, so you were going to fight Alex Rutter, weren't you? But unfortunately, you got injured.
Tell us
a little bit about that situation. What happened? What was the injury and how's it healed?
Well, it was the top of my neck. Went to see him physio and stuff, and he said he thought a ruptured bone in my disc in my spine.
Yeah.
So I just rested it for about 4 months, 3 months, and perfect now.
Yeah.
I done it. I did it in weights. Weight heavy and that. And
Like that. Just trying to get one of them bodies for Instagram, aren't you?
Yeah, that's what it is.
In the gym here, and I'm just looking around, and you're surrounded by talented fighters.
Yeah.
You know, and of course you've got Terry Turbo Flanagan in here as well, the WBO lightweight champ. I mean, what's it like working in a gym where you've got so many talented fighters?
Thrive off each other, and we learn things off each other as well. Like, we'll watch what the other person does, and then you might try and do it, it might work for you.
Yeah.
There's that many different people in here, you can. Oh, it's good.
Yeah.
I love it in here, mate. Best gym, best gym.
Yes. And do you get some good sparring in here? I know a lot of guys are in here a bit heavier than you, but do you get a lot of good sparring?
You get people in.
Yeah.
Got some more from that Sean Creel's coming tomorrow.
Right. Well, we know a few people. Who's it? He's not.
It's like that super featherweight, whatever.
Is it Michael?
Nah, Gorton, Gomez.
Might be Artie Vaughn.
Yeah, he's there now, isn't he?
Sound quality. All right then, so hoping for a big year from you this year. Obviously, you've got your own ambitions.
Yeah.
And we wish you all the very best in your sort of campaign this year. It's Kallum Dieth in the house. Watch out.